everyone, welcome to the channel. My name is Philly Beats You. This video is basically going to be going over how to get the Space Time Distortions in Pokemon Legends Arceus to respawn and keep spawning again and again and again so you can continue on your adventure and get these distortions and hunt rare Pokemon and get a lot of treasures and stuff. All right, let's get into it. So the first question we're going to answer is, when do Space Time Distortions start to form? The answer to that is once you beat Cleaver in the beginning of the game. Beat that boss battle and then they will start to spawn throughout your game, wherever you are, any location. Now let's talk about how to get these space-time distortions to appear. When you're in an area and you decide to leave it, let's say we return to the village, you're going to 100% reset the whole entire chance and encounters of it happening by going in and out of an area. So going from example, the Obsidian Fieldlands to Jubilee Village or any of the other locations to Jubilee Village, you are then resetting how it counts. Now, the moment I go here to this guy and walk into the encounter, for example, so I'm going to go into this postlands area, you're going to then begin the timer. So as soon as we start, it's going to start counting. All right, it's begun. As soon as I walk in here, now it is counting, counting, counting. And information that has come out from Serebii, we don't know where that data mine came from as of this video. So when you're in a zone for 5 minutes, you have a 10% chance increase of it showing up. When you're in there for 10 minutes, you'll notice that you may have a 20% chance increase. 15 minutes, 20%, 25 minutes, 25%, and 40 minutes, 25%. So basically what's happening is every 5 minutes, you're getting a roll on whether it's going to appear. And these larger timeframes that you see over here are going to determine the chance increase during these intervals. Now, if you're in the early game, you're going to have a smaller chance increase per time. And when you're in the post game, which is after the credits roll, you're then going to have a much more higher chance of those spawning. Another very important piece of information is this on the screen. It says, there is no way to force a space-time distortion to happen as they are random, but you know where they are in terms of the randomization based off the previous chart we saw. But they are checked every 5 minutes you are in an area. Resetting the state of an area by skipping to a later time will reset this, and battling a Pokemon or being in a menu will pause the timer. So if you want to get something to spawn, the reality is you just have to wait that specific amount of time. So every 5 minutes, you have a chance of this happening. And if you want to refer back to the other screenshot, that'll be there too. I will also link down the page where this is all located in the description below. So there are a few things you don't want to do when you're going to deal with the space-time distortions. One, you don't want to battle any Pokemon. Two, you don't want to battle any trainers. Three, you don't want to be in any menus. And the biggest one, do not walk out of the zone and come back in. Do not go back to Jubilife and come back in. If you do that, you are literally resetting it all over again for the space-time distortion. And once you get your first space-time distortion, simply just wait again until the next one happens. It sucks. Sometimes you might have that really bad RNG, but the only way to do this is just wait. And what you can do is just figure out what to do while you're in the area. You can catch Pokemon, no problem. That's not going to affect whether it spawns or not. You can explore, you can move around, but the idea is to wait within the zone and not engage into any battles or anything like that. So on the map, the three biggest places that people are going to hunt specific Pokemon is in the Crimson Mirelands. People will try to get the Cyndaquil evolution line in the space-time distortions. If you're trying to go for Rowlet's evolution line, you're going to go to the Coronet Highlands. Again, this is post-game, so please remember, this is after the credits roll, you'll start to see these Pokemon here. And if you're going for Oshawott, you're going to want to go to the Alabaster Icelands in order for them to show up over here. So these are the three locations that you're going to want to just hang out in and wait and hunt for your starters. Shiny hunting the starters is going to be intense, so good luck with that over here, but that's basically the method you have to do in order to do this. I also highly recommend you check out Austin John's video if you want to physically see the testing happen, because he did this for about 12 hours and tested all of it out. What happens if you are in a zone versus if you go out of a zone versus if you're going to battles, things like that. He does all the testing and he got some great results. So check out that video. That's also linked down below, but you'll probably see this when you're looking up space-time distortions. So now you guys know how space-time distortions work. Basically, just go into an area, wait 5 minutes, see what happens in those 5 minutes. The chances are going to reroll. You have much better chances if you are post-game than if you are pre-game. So if you're in the post-game, you're going to have better and higher increased rates of them spawning. Remember, do not exit the area because it's going to reset. Do not battle as it'll extend your time or basically pause the time that it's naturally occurring. You have to be in the overworld and nothing should be happening. No Pokemon battles, no trainer battles, and it should be that simple. I feel like I've repeated myself so many times. You guys get the point of the video by now. So if you enjoyed this video, make sure to hit that like button, subscribe for more easy content like this. I tried to make this really short where I didn't have to explain how to do a whole space time distortion because you guys probably know what to do. Again, my video for that is going to be linked over here somewhere on the screen. Thank you for watching and subscribing, supporting the channel. And if any information comes out, you know I'm going to update you. My name is Philly Beats You. Thank you very much. And I'll see you in the next Pokemon Legends Arceus video. Take care.